What's up, guys? Jedi Warrior back again with another LEGO Star Wars review. This one from Rogue One back in 2016 is the TIE Striker. I don't see a TIE ship in this model. I don't. But it is a cool one. So let's start with the minifigures. Wow, this set's kind of dusty. You get four of them. You get a TIE Striker pilot, which is just a TIE fighter pilot, a shore trooper, a rebel trooper, and an Imperial landing crew member, or officer, I think is what it's called. But the TIE pilot says it's new on the box, but the only thing that's usually new on the TIE pilots is just a little bit of tweaking in the printing. They don't usually change much. The little gripe I've always had with the TIE pilots and stormtrooper helmets is the molds are usually the same. And me being blind, it's hard to distinguish which head is or which helmet is which. So I frequently get my stormtrooper and pilot's helmets swapped around on accident. The shore trooper looks really good. To me, he's just another trooper, though. I mean, he's got a lot of really good printing on him. I'll admit that. And a different helmet mold that I haven't seen before. The Rebel Trooper is the same trooper that was in the AT-ST from Rogue One, other than the fact that his helmet and face were different. Which, the helmet, the only different thing about it is it doesn't have the flashlight print or the flashlight mold on this, or molded onto the side. Face, I don't know what was different about it. The landing crew officer has a new helmet that I have never seen. It's kind of like a Death Star gunner helmet or Imperial gunner helmet, but it's more rounded in the back. It has the upraised kind of brow on the front of it. And he also has two, like, the traffic cone, or traffic light cone pieces that you see a lot of construction workers use to direct traffic. On this TIE Striker, the front canopy lowers, and the top canopy, which is actually fully built up, it's not the turtle shell canopy piece they've used for years. You can set your pilot down in there. You will have to turn him to get the pistol that he uses past the rim or front rail of the cockpit. If you store him in there with his gun, I always do. There's no studs down there, but his feet wedge between. It's like a 2x1 flat tile, but there's a piece in there to where it wedges between his feet and it holds him in place. Then he has, like, it's a droid body, but it's in black, and it has a control panel in the front of it to give him his controls. And you close that up. The back also opens, and there's a little storage area in there. You have binoculars, there's a pistol, an extra gun in there, and a walkie-talkie on the side. But what I don't like particularly about this is that I took this out on mine, but inside there's an entire, like, Technic build that serves no purpose but to take up most of the space in there. So I did not like that. I ended up taking mine out. The primary feature on this is that the wings can raise and lower. There's two levers on the back that are actually Technic arms, and you just pull those or push those up, and it raises the wings into flight position. The wings kind of look like the wings on a TIE Interceptor. They're pointed toward the front, and the TIE Striker is actually a bomber. So there's two spring-loaded shots on the front that you just heard I shot one off. That if you want to do a bombing run, lower the wings, and that's the bombing position on the fighter. But I don't really have much to say about this. Oh, the wings do have some stickers on them, and there is actually some struts on the front of the wings, or on the top of the wings. I'm just noticing now, you can hear my wings kind of creaking. I've had this set for a while, it's kind of old and decrepit. But that is about it for this review, guys. Peace out.